Well, hey folks, as you know, we recently had an election here in Alberta, and I did quite a bit of election coverage. One of the things that was talked about during the election was stuff to do with healthcare. And one of the questions that came up when we were at the healthcare forum at the library was informed consent, or what they're also calling the opt-out system. Right now, what we have is an opt-in system for organ donation. So if you want to be an organ donor, you've got to fill out a little card, you've got to let people know, and then they put it on your license. It says that you're a donor. If you happen to pass away in a car accident or something like that, then they'll know. They'll look at your donor card, they'll look at your ID card, see that you're a donor. What's being proposed is that everybody would be a donor just by default, and you'd have to opt out. And that's what's happened in Halifax, Nova Scotia. That's where I'm from, where my family is from. And my dad actually had a double lung transplant. So, he's interested in making sure that, organs are available for people that need them. And he pushed for this quite a bit. And so during the election, this question was asked. And I noticed that a lot of the politicians and people talking about it didn't really fully understand the concept. So I sent my dad some questions. He responded back. And actually, right now, he's enjoying and loving retirement. Him and mom are in Mexico. So I didn't want to bother them with, doing a Skype or FaceTime interview, but he wrote back and gave me some answers, and maybe next time I'm in Halifax, I'll have a sit-down interview with him. But what I want to do is read you the question and answers here so that you can learn a little bit about organ donation and informed consent. So my first question was, who are you? He said, I'm William Fougere, a.k.a. your dad. I said, tell us about your transplant. He said, I got really sick in 2005. And as a result of breathing in airborne contaminated particulate, I developed a lung disease, bronchitis obliterans with bronchiectasis. That required a double lung transplant. My lungs were turning into plaque, therefore not permitting them to work properly. It was a rapid development, which within the year left me debilitated. Within 2 years, I was using a home oxygen all the time. My wife and I had to pack up and move to Toronto to await the surgery. 2 weeks to the day after my 60th birthday, we were given the notice that I would get new lungs, and they were the healthiest lungs anyone could ask for. The process of the transplant wasn't as bad as the wait once we got to Toronto. 6+ years later, and my new lungs are working perfectly. O2 levels are at 100% as compared to the pre-transplant levels of only 20%. So I ask, what is an opt-out system mean? He says, simply put, it means that upon your demise, it is presumed that if viable, your organs can be used to save other lives. If this is not your desire, you can opt out. This in itself is not fail-safe because your next of kin can, at the time of your death, request that your organs are not harvested. This is why it's so important to discuss your wishes with your family. Why should it be that way? I asked. He said, in Canada, 90% of the population agrees that organ donation is a good thing and that it should happen. However, only about 20% of Canadians have signed organ donor cards. That is a huge disparity that can only be increased by this new policy. Should the rest of Canada follow Nova Scotia, I asked. One word answer, yes. I asked, how does this bill passing make you feel? And my dad said, I'm elated with this, as it will hopefully improve wait times for those requiring organ and other body transplants. Remember, a single organ donor may save up to 8 people, and a single tissue donor may enhance the lives of up to 50 people. You have the power to save lives and improve the quality of life of those in need of any form of transplant. So there you have it. Coming from an expert, somebody who has received an organ transplant and fought for the informed consent process in Halifax, Nova Scotia, and now Nova Scotia is going to be putting through a bill that switches everything over so that everybody is presumed to be an organ donor unless they go in and say, you know, I need to remove that organ donor thing, that's not what I want to do. And as I said, because you know, there's a high percentage of people that say they want organ donation to happen, but only a very small percentage of people that actually go in and opt into the system that we have here, like in Alberta. So let me know what you think about this in the comments section. You know, do you think that you want to donate your organs? Have you filled out that that little organ donor card? Have you discussed it with your family? What do you think about informed consent or an opt-out system rather than an opt-in system? I want to know what you think, and if you think it'll work in Alberta, thanks so much for watching Community TV. We'll see you again soon.